to talk about commensalism. So we are already done with mutualism, a very interesting video we have made. Now it's time for commensalism. So commensalism humne padha tha ki it is a kind of relationship in which one of the species got benefited and the other species is not affected at all. It means that it remains neutral. Zero ka matlab hai, it is not harmed and it is not benefited as well. So there will be no major effect. Okay, if there will be some effect, that will be negligible totally. So usko hum kya kar sakte hain? Neglect kar sakte hain, agar thoda bahut effect hoga to bhi. Now, it's time to see the examples. We are clear with the definition, we are clear with the symbols. Plus and zero is the symbol for commensalism. Now, examples ki baat karte hain, which is the most important part in each of the population interaction. We have to go through each and every example very, very carefully. Right? So the first example, let me take the third one first because it is the most common one. Cattle ergot and grazing cattles. Obviously, agar aap ek gaon ke ilake se ho, to aapne cattles ko ghas khate hue zarur dekha hoga aur unke bagal mein aapne ek ergot ko hamesha dekha hoga. So what kind of relationship is between ergot and cattle? Let me explain this to you. When the cattle used to graze the grass or the vegetation, then it used to decrease the vegetation count. Okay, जो grass है वहाँ पर जो छोटे मोटे पौधे हैं, herbs हैं, वो obviously क्या होंगे वहाँ पर कम हो जाएंगे. And that decrease in vegetation count will obviously clear the ground. Right? So whenever they are grazing, they used to clear the ground because they are grazing on the grass or on vegetation which is present on this ground initially. So initially जहाँ पर जो घास वास present थी, उस सब पे cattle जो है feed कर चुका है, तो वो घास अब साफ हो चुकी है. और वो जब चलता है तो उसके जब पैर पड़ते हैं जमीन पे, due to that pressure, due to lack of cattle, also declines the vegetation count. So in that specific area, the grass will be less, or we can say the vegetation will be less, so the insects can be easily detected by the ergot. Ergot can easily see the insect because it used to feed on insects. Right? So if there will be less vegetation count at the area where the cattle is feeding initially, there are more probability, there are more chances of the insects to be seen by the ergot. Okay? So, जब ये बहुत ही ज्यादा एक्सपोज हो जाएंगे, बहुत ही ज्यादा दिखने लगेंगे, तो कैटल उन पे फीड कर पाएगी. इफ देयर इज नो तो एर्गेट उन पे फीड कर पाएगी. इफ देयर इज नो कैटल, देन इट बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द एर्गेट टू फाइंड इंसेक्ट्स इन सच अ लार्ज वेजिटेशन. ओके, देयरफॉर ये दोनों हमेशा आसपास रहते हैं. हियर द एर्गेट विल श्योरली गेट बेनिफिटेड बिकॉज इट इज गेटिंग एन एक्सपोजर टू इंसेक्ट्स. वो क्या कर रही है, उसको इंसेक्ट्स दिख रहे हैं. इंसेक्ट्स भी मतलब कि सब कुछ ठीक से ऑब्जर्व कर पा रहे हैं. दोनों जो चीजें हैं बहुत ही ज्यादा प्रोमिनेंटली विजिबल होती हैं उस टाइम पे, बिकॉज द वेजिटेशन इज क्वाइट लेस. ड्यू टू दिस फैक्ट दे आर बेनिफिटेड एज दे विल गेट मोर नंबर ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स, सो दे कैन फीड देमसेल्फ कंप्लीटली, एंड द कैटल विल नॉट हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ हार्म और नॉट हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ बेनिफिट. दे आर जस्ट फीडिंग द ग्रास, दे आर जस्ट ग्रेजिंग द ग्रास, सो दे डू नॉट हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ थिंग टू डू विद एर्गेट. राइट? सो दे विल बी न्यूट्रल. This is the first relationship. Now let me tell you the second one. Clownfish and sea anemone used to live quite close to each other. Now the clownfish can be eaten by different kind of predators. Okay, and to be protected from those predator, it used to go to sea anemone. The sea anemone have stinging cells or stinging tentacles. Tentacles which will attack the predator. So similar case है यार, यहाँ पे एक बहुत ही simple चीज समझ के देखो. For example, these are the stinging tentacles of an anemone. Okay, this is the clownfish, let's say. If there is a predator which is coming, there is another clownfish which is not associated with the stinging this tentacle. So if this is the predator, it can eat this clownfish or it can attack this clownfish because there is no savior. But in this case, if this predator will come here to eat the clownfish, the tentacles will attack on it. So The clownfish, for the purpose of protection, remains in close association with the sea anemone, which have stinging tentacles. So sea anemone ke paas rahega, to sea will act as a bodyguard. So the sea anemone has a natural mechanism, okay, to kill the predators. It's totally fine for them. So they are not getting benefited or they are not getting harmed. They are just serving their duty. ये specially clownfish के लिए कुछ नहीं कर रहे, वो उनका रोज का काम है. अगर कोई भी predator आता तो वो मारते ही. But here clownfish got an additional advantage of protection, because clownfish, if present alone, can be easily killed by the predator and can be easily consumed. But in this case, if it is living with sea anemone, तो sea anemone भाई उसका bodyguard है. और अब अगर कोई आया predator, तो stinging tentacle फेंक के मारेगा बहुत बुरे तरीके से, और जो है predator उसको kill कर देगा. तो this is also a kind of relationship where this will become neutral, okay, and this will got benefit, a benefit of protection. Now let's talk about some other example. The barnacles which are growing on the back of whale. Since the barnacles always used to attach themselves on the back of whale, which is quite large. So एक बहुत ही बड़ी whales पे अगर barnacles हैं भी, तो barnacle अगर उनसे कोई फायदा उठा भी रहे हैं, then whale is not going to get much affected, that's for sure. So the whale is not going to get affected, it will become neutral, and the barnacles can get benefit, some of the important benefits such as nutrition from the whale, and they complete their whole life cycle on the back of whale, right? जहां पर भी वो अटैच होते हैं वेल की बैक पे, दे कॉज डीपिगमेंटेशन ऑफ द स्किन ऑफ वेल, एंड आफ्टर दैट दे सर्वाइव फॉर द होल लाइफ ऑन देयर बैक, राइट? सो ऑब्वियसली दे विल बी डेराइविंग एटलीस्ट अ लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन, व्हिच इज नेग्लिजिबल फॉर वेल. वेल इज लाइक वेरी लार्ज, उसके लिए छोटे मोटे कीड़े मकोड़े उसके शरीर पर चलते रहे, उसे कोई खास फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. सो जीरो एंड प्लस, इट इज ऑल्सो एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कॉमेंसलिज्म. Now the last one and the most important one, which is already got asked in the examination, orchid living as an epiphyte on mango plant. So there is the mango, right? काफी मोटी ब्रांच है मैंगो की. यहां पर क्या करेगा, as an epiphyte. Epi means upper part, phyte means plant. So growing on the upper part of a plant or on the branch of a plant is epiphytic, right? So orchid क्या कर रहा है, as an epiphyte grow कर रहा है mango पे. It means that वो mango की branch के ऊपर grow कर रहा है. Okay, it is quite clear from the name itself. Epi means upper and phytic means plant. It means that the orchid is living in the upper part of mango branch, right? So वहाँ से grow करेगा, so obviously it will derive some of the nutrition and support as well. All those things are negligible for mango. So the orchid is getting some benefit, but the mango is not getting affected at all, right? So there are some most important examples: orchid and mango, okay, barnacles and whale, there is sea anemone and clownfish, and there is cattle alligator relationship. So आप इन सबसे आसानी से पता लगा सकते हैं कि कौन बेनिफिट होगा कौन बेनिफिट नहीं होगा. आई होप दैट ऑल दीज रिलेशनशिप्स आर क्वाइट क्लियर टू यू. These four examples of commensalism are very important from examination point of view. तो आपको सारे के सारे याद होने चाहिए, और उनकी relationship में कौन positive है कौन neutral है ये भी याद होना चाहिए. So I have explained all these things to you and I expect कि आपको सब समझ में आया होगा. So if you really got this video, then hit like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much.